Ah, man. So, I'll be honest, this is not what I expected. Did not believe I would be fighting a Malzahar.
A weapon's virtue is proven in combat.
Yeah.
I find your skill lacking. You may thank me when this is over. Do nothing if you wish to be nothing. I'm old enough to know that.
Well, this was uneventful.
The luxury of mercy.
Didn't Malzahar's passive used to last like one full second? Am I crazy on that? I feel like that's actually what it used to do. Back when he was like pick ban, I'm
first blood. Feigning innocence is so time-consuming. Purity of form, purity of function.
You want old Sion back? That's one I've never heard. Can I just straight dive this guy? I think if I had press the attack, I could. Oh, fuck off, turret. I didn't think that last shot would go. Is a bad matchup for us? At level 6, it probably becomes a bad matchup. For now, though, well, not so much.
It's not lies that
yeah, he flashed.
But the sharpness of the truth.
How do I outplay Malzahar ult? Is he not just gonna stand right in front of me and kill me with it?
This is your best.
Ow. Graves, dude, buddy, pal, friendo, guy. That's a little bit aggravating. Yep. 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 Graves with the, I'm helping, but not really. I'm just gonna stand here. It's okay. You got this, right? Play. What's the reasoning behind Emacs for this lane? Well, Twitch chat, I wanted my damage, gap closer, escape move, stun, attack speed move. Oh, sorry, I'm just tired of explaining that every fucking game. Yana, gap closed, flashed, gap closed. No issue here, right? I can't think of a single problem with this. Guys, should I max my E? It gives me damage and attack speed and is a gap closer and is also an escape move. But Q gives me base damage scaling. I could get like 50 more damage by maxing it. That's you guys. That's what you sound like. I think buying QSS loses this matchup for me really hard. I think buying QSS is how I lose here. That guy really didn't think I was gonna die.
Our journey will lead us.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so we went from me solo killing Malzahar to Malzahar just ulting and killing me from full HP now. Not sure what to do about that one.
Employs many methods.
Rampage.
Only coward.
Double kill.
Mind your manners.
Oh. Oh shit. Oh, she ulted forward. Huh. Yeah, I can TP. Well, what? What do you mean we have no way to get to them?
An ally has been slain.
What? How do you get kited by a bunch? That worked out, I'd say. Listen, you have no mana, buddy.
Thank you.
The number one way to beat Kiryana is to first have banned Kiryana. That sucks. I got ranged. Okay, I don't even know Twitch chat. This went from me first blooding Malzahar to Malzahar having two levels on me. Wait a minute, I just realized Kiryana's not even their jungler. Kiryana was, mentally, I thought she was their jungler the whole time. And I'm kind of realizing, wait, she was actually just their mid laner roaming top that many times. I don't think we possibly win this. Oh, that sucked. I think I should have ran back into Malzahar and eaten his ult to die. That would have been better than dying to the Israel ult. How do we get a catch on their jungler, then our jungler gets caught? I do not think that trying to trap their team was a good idea. Well, I think that was about the best case scenario for me. Considering I had two people running at me that whole fight, and then my team lost the 4v3. Though, at a certain point, it's just like, why is Qiyana unbanned? I mean, I was just having fun kiting those guys and stealing his jungle and farming mid and shit. Then I realized my team lost, and I'm like, oh, okay. Ah. I felt like I had a lot of counterplay there. It's not like I built Styrix Gauge and Merc Treads or anything. Man, from first blooding Malzahar to being down three levels. Yeah, I don't know. These have been some fun games. I really enjoy these kinds of games. Not sure what I'm supposed to do to win them, but, you know, they're pretty fun. I don't know why Qiyana is unbanned. Seems to be a bad idea. I'm